Hello everyone, welcome to MifraTech. Today in this section we learn about IoT based weather monitoring system. So this IoT wireless weather station, we are mainly using Arduino, a ESP8266 Wi-Fi module and a ThingSpeak as cloud in order to store the data and access the data cloud. So this introduction we'll see about this project. So this global warming has led to unpredictable climate researchers. Like mainly in order to know the weather changing conditions, like what are the different parameters that will change the weather. So these weather monitoring is very helpful in different aspects. So here we are mainly using different sensors in order to detect different weather parameters, and we are going to analyze them using a sim cloud server. So in this project we learn like first how to build such a wireless IoT based weather station, which mainly measures critical environmental factors like temperature, humidity and pressure. So here we are using Arduino board along with the DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor, PMP180 pressure sensor and ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, like in order to send the data through Wi-Fi. So the DHT11 temperature sensor mainly senses the temperature and humidity, while a PMP180 gives us a pressure, which gives a relative pressure, altitude values, absolute pressure values, and ESP8266 mainly it is like a Wi-Fi module. It is used based for internet connectivity, like in order to send the data through Wi-Fi, like wirelessly. We are using this ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. One more, as I told, BMP180 is mainly help us to know the what is the pressure values and altitude values. And in order to send this data, we are using a ThingSpeak, which is a cloud platform, IoT cloud platform, which enables us to live monitoring from anywhere in the world. We can monitor these wireless weather station, and we can also see the what are the different values of those temperature, pressure values, humidity values, and we can also like even graph to analyze what are the variations. Also, we can see using this ThingSpeak cloud server. So the components we used will be Arduino Uno microcontroller, as you can see here, and ESP8266 Wi-Fi module in order to send the data through wirelessly, and DHT11, this is a temperature and humidity sensor, BMP180 a pressure sensor, and breadboard in order to make the connections, and there will be jumper wires in order to connect all the components. So this is the circuit diagram, as you can see here, for the Arduino Uno Nano. So this Arduino Uno microcontroller have connected for ESP8266 Wi-Fi module here, as you can see here. So have connected ground connection to ground, and power supply provided from the 5 volts, and next the different connection I have connected to this Wi-Fi module. Next DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor I have connected. Next we connected, so as you can see here, BMP180 temperature, that is pressure sensor, I have connected to analog pins here. So these are the different connections for this project. So the DHT11 temperature sensor mainly requires a 5 volts power supply that I have connected from the Arduino, and data pin I connected one, that is a pin 5 from the one wire communication, that is digital pin, as you can see here. DHT11 I connected to pin number D5 of Arduino Uno microcontroller. So BMP180 pressure sensor requires a 3.3 power volt supply, so that I connected from the Arduino. So as you can see here, 3v3 I provided to this BMP180. Next, this BMP180 uses serial that is I2C communication. So I have to provide both serial clock and serial data in order to connect this. So I have connected serial clock to A4, that is analog pin of Arduino Uno microcontroller, and serial data to A5 of the Arduino Uno. So this is in order to interface this BMP180. Next, the ESP8266 Wi-Fi module requires a 3.3 power supply that I connected from the Arduino microcontroller board. Next, it has a transmitter and a receiver pins. So this transmitter pin I connected to pin number, digital pin number 2 of Arduino Uno, and receiver pin to pin number 3 of Arduino Uno. This is for serial communication. So these are the 3 components mainly used in this weather wireless IoT based weather station. So after connecting all the components, so as you can see here, in order to detect, this is the table which it tells us what are the different connection in order to connect all the components to this Arduino microcontroller board. So ESP8266 VCC I have connected to 3.3 volts from Arduino, and ESP8266 reset pin also 3.3 and CHPD pin 3.3 volts, all 3 pins. Next RS2 Arduino pin transmitter, and transmitter pin we have to connect to receiver pin of Arduino Uno microcontroller. Next ground to ground. Next from BMP180 we have to do I2C connection, that is VCC to 5 volts, ground to ground. Serial data I have connected to analog pin A4 of Arduino Uno microcontroller board, and serial clock to A5 of Arduino microcontroller board. Next DST11 we have 3 pins, VCC, data and ground. VCC I have connected to 5 of, that is 5 volts from the Arduino microcontroller board, and data pin to D5, that is digital pin number 5 of microcontroller board, and ground pin I have connected to ground. So these are the required connection for this weather monitoring system. So after making all the connection, so this is how all the making the connection the project will look like, as you can see here, weather monitoring system. So after that, we have to share the data through the cloud. We have to set up the ThingSpeak channel. For that we have to open ThingSpeak in any platform, in any browser you open the ThingSpeak. After that, in the ThingSpeak you can both aggregate, visualize and analyze the live data from those sensors in the cloud. So you can also control the devices using this ThingSpeak. So you can send data to ThingSpeak from your devices, and even you can create an instant visualization of the live data and send alerts using the web services like Twitter. And this ThingSpeak has an integrated support from the numerical computing software, that is MATLAB. And MATLAB also allows us to ThingSpeak users to write and execute MATLAB code for perform a pre-processing, visualization and analyzing of the data. And this ThingSpeak takes minimum of 15 seconds to update your reading. Like whenever it is continuously taking reading from the sensor, that will be updated within 15 seconds. So we'll see how to set up this ThingSpeak. First ThingSpeak account we have to set up. First, for that we have to create a channel on the ThingSpeak. For that we have to first sign up on the ThingSpeak platform. We open any browser and open ThingSpeak cloud, where we have to sign up. In case you have already an account in ThingSpeak, means you can sign in using your ID and password. Otherwise you can create your own account after going to this website, that is www.thingspeak.com. So as you can see here, this is the home page of ThingSpeak website. So after going this, you can enter your details and log in here, or you can create your own again new account here. So after that you have to verify your email ID, and then you have to click on, as you can see here. So after creating this signing up, have to create a channel for your data. Like in order to collect the data from those sensors through the Wi-Fi, we have to create one channel. For that, after sign in has been done to this ThingSpeak, after verifying your account, we have to create a new channel by clicking on new channel button. There will be like new channel button available, so you have to click on that. There are different things available, as you can see here. Channel ID is given, and a name you can give here, weather station or whatever your project, and you have to, you can give here the description about the project, and there will be like field 1, field field 2, field 3. So these are like in order to collect those in order to display the different data. So here I am using mainly humidity, temperature and pressure data I am displaying. So I am using a field 1 humidity, field 2 temperature, and in field 3 a pressure. So after clicking on new channel, you have to enter the name and description as I told earlier. So after that you have to enter the name of your data, like humidity, temperature, whatever the field you are displaying. So after filling all those details, if you are detecting or if we are displaying more fields, means you can also use more fields. Like in the checkbox there will be a field option, you can enter the name of the field and description of the data. We can write this. So after writing all this, we have to save the channel. So after saving these details, have to get a API key. Like in order to send the data to this ThingSpeak, there will be like unique API key is available, that we have to get. So in order to send data to ThingSpeak, we need a unique API key, so which we will use later in our code. Like we will use this API code in our programming while dumping the programming to the Arduino Uno microcontroller board. So that API key we have to give it in the code in order to detect or in order to collect the data shared by those controller board. So we have to click on API keys button. Like in order to get a unique API key for uploading your sensor data, so there will be API keys button available, that you have to click in order to get this API key. So after that, here as you can see, here write API key, there will be in our generate new API key here available. So we will use this API key in our code. So next we'll program it in the Arduino IDE. So in our to program, we have to use Arduino IDE because we are using Arduino Uno microcontroller here. So there will be like different libraries we have to include in program. Mainly we are using ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. So we have to include ash include Wi-Fi.h header files, then DHT11 header file, and then libraries wire.h, soft serial.h, and standard library and BMP180. So after including all these required libraries, we have to write the program. After that, we have to enter the Wi-Fi name and password, like in order to send the data through the Wi-Fi, and then also we have to enter the API key that we copied from the ThingSpeak channel. So as you can see, you have to define, enter your Wi-Fi name, you have to write here, enter the password. After that, that API key, API server name, that is api.thingspeak.com. After that, string API key, whatever the API key you copied from the ThingSpeak channel, that we have to copy here in the code. So after doing all this, we have to set up, like we have to do the setup. In the void setup function, mainly we have to do void.begin and pressure dot, like we have to write the begin of those all the included libraries. After that, we have to set the baud rate, serial.begin 9600, we have to set the baud rate. After that, a delay of 10 millisecond is given here, and DST begin. Again, in the serial monitor, we are printing what is the, like using the AT command, we are checking the Wi-Fi module. So after that, whatever the temperature and pressure, temperature and humidity data sent by the DHT11 temperature, that we are going to read and print it, and that we are going to send to the ThingSpeak channel. And similarly, pressure values. So this is the required program for this project. So after writing the program and uploading it in the microcontroller board, so after once it has been dumped into the microcontroller successfully, so if you run the program, so after that, as I told, we have to connect the Arduino with the laptop or choose the board. After connect is choosing the port correctly, then uploading the button. So after that, you will see Wi-Fi ID, password, all those things on the serial monitor. We can see all this data in the serial monitor in the Arduino ID itself, and we can also see in the ThingSpeak channel. So as you can see, these are the different like weather station in ThingSpeak channel. We can also plot the graph according to vary what are the different varying temperature, humidity, and pressure values. So as you can see here, weather station values. So in the ThingSpeak, we can easily visualize our data. So this ThingSpeak will be helpful in visualizing the data and analyzing the data through remotely. So this is the complete code for this weather station project. So in this way, you can connect all those sensors and microcontrollers in order to make IoT based wireless weather station, and you can also visualize and analyze the data in the ThingSpeak cloud platform. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you.